Welcome to the Reclaim Me channel, and today we talk about recovering data from VMFS file system. This is a relatively modern file system. The first release was in 2002. By that time, developers have already known a lot of good techniques which were borrowed for VMFS. However, we should not forget that VMFS was designed for a special task, namely to store files from virtual machines, and therefore does not have some capabilities which are common to general purpose file systems like NTFS or EXT. Up to the fact that earlier VMFS versions did not support directories just because they were not needed then. VMFS, similarly to EXT file system, uses inodes and indirect blocks, and also, similarly to Microsoft structured storage, VMFS uses two different cluster sizes and a dedicated repository for small files. For very small files, smaller than 1 kilobyte, the data is stored inside corresponding inodes, like resident files in NTFS. Almost all file-related metadata has signatures, which facilitate file recovery given that the VMFS volume was created on a single disk. VMFS can combine several disks into a Gboard, and in this it is very similar to hybrid file systems like BTRFS and ZFS. Additionally, the VMFS driver can use non-contiguous areas on a single disk. However, no complex RAID layouts are supported and only Gboard is used. Now let's look at how VMFS is organized. So we have a physical disk partitioned with MBR and GPT. Then 2048 free sectors go, followed by the volume header and the extent header. After the headers, there are 2766 reserved sectors, followed by the 256 megabyte segments. Segments in turn are cut into clusters storing data. The large clusters are 1 megabyte in size. In the beginning of the VMFS volume, there are inodes, indirect block pointers, and a repository for small files, small cluster storage. All these metadata entities are described as files stored in the root file system directory so that the VMFS driver can expand them when needed. Then files themselves are stored. Now let's look more closer at inodes. An inode has a fixed size 2 kilobyte. One kilobyte is used to store the set of standard metadata, and one more kilobyte is used for payload. Standard metadata includes the date and time of file creation, the file size and the file type, and the most part of the first 1 kilobyte is unused. The payload can contain either 256 pointers uh, They can be either pointers to the large clusters or indirect block pointers or pointers to the small clusters or file content for files smaller than 1 kilobyte. Note that the payload always stores only one of these objects. That is, there will be no payload storing, say, indirect block pointers and small clusters, either one or the other. The large clusters are 1 megabyte in size and are counted from the beginning of the VMFS volume. The small clusters are typically 8 kilobyte in size and are stored in a special file. When a file is deleted, the payload in its inode is overwritten with zeros, destroying all cluster pointers to the file. That's why there is no undelete in VMFS file system. As I said, VMFS forms a JBOD by cutting the disks into 256 megabyte segments. Let's look at this a little more closely. Imagine that we have two physical disks on which VMFS driver creates two partitions using MBR and GPT. In the beginning of each partition, there are 2048 free sectors, followed by the volume header and the extent header, in which the numbers of the first and the last segments are stored. Then 32,766 sectors are resolved by the VMFS driver. After them, the disk space is cut into segments. Let it be three segments on each disk. Segments are numbered sequentially starting from zero. Thus, we have extent zero, consisting of segments from 0 to 2, and extent 1, including segments from 3 to 5. Extents, if there are many of them, are combined into a GBOD by ascending the segments numbers. Data recovery from a VMFS volume consists of two steps. First, you need to reassemble the volume from the extents and then to read file system metadata, namely inodes and directories. Inodes and directories are recovered automatically, and manual recovery does not make sense because metadata either exists or not. If you cannot reassemble the volume from the extents automatically, you can try to build a JBOD manually, assuming that all extents start from the same offset on all disks. And if you know at least the location of one of the extents, you can try to use its parameters on other disks. Cowing does not work well on a VMFS volume. VMFS is used to store disk images, which are large and tend to be fragmented. Cowing will find files, for example JPEG, on those disk images and mix them. In case of several virtual machines stored on a VMFS volume, with cowing you even will not be able to tell reliably to which virtual machine the file belongs. Theoretically, you can try partition recovery. In case of Reclaiming Pro, use find partitions capability and search the volume for the internal file systems like in TFS. But this approach is unlikely to work due to fragmentation. Let's look at how to do VMFS recovery in Reclaiming Pro. First, connect all the disks from the VMFS volume. I have two disk image files from a VMFS volume. Ensure that VMFS is checked as target partition type. If Reclaimy Pro can reassemble the VMFS volume from the extents, select it and click Start Scan for the file recovery. Click OK and start. Let's look what Reclaimy Pro brought. Looks good. If Reclaimy Pro has not reassembled the volume, select all the disks one by one and do partition recovery on them using Find Partitions. From the partitions found, select VMFS partition and add it to the list. Select all the VMFS partitions and click Manual Rate. Arrange the partitions by ascending the segments numbers. In my case, first the extent with segments from 0 to 30 goes, and then the extent containing segments from 31. Next, create a GBOT on them. Launch file recovery on the main ULG board by clicking Start Scan. Uncheck all the file systems except VMFS. Recovery looks good. That's all about VMFS recovery. Reclaimy team was with you. See you soon.